हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू पार्ट 53 ऑफ एडवांस ईकॉम सीरीज इन लारावल 7। सो वी विल कंटिन्यू मर्जिंग आवर ईकॉम टेम्पलेट टू आवर वेबसाइट। ओके, सो वी आर वर्किंग ऑन दिस फ्रंट एंड फ्रॉम द लास्ट टू वीडियोस फ्रॉम पार्ट 51। वी हैव स्टार्टेड वर्किंग ऑन द फ्रंट एंड ऑफ आवर वेबसाइट एंड दिस इज द 53rd वीडियो एंड हियर ऑल्सो वी आर गोइंग टू मर्ज आवर टेम्पलेट एज वेल। सी, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल we will cover this home page. We want to make our home page like this. Okay, so in last video you have seen that we able to create front layout, front footer, front header and front sidebar files along with the other files, along with the index controller. All the settings we have done, routes also we have done. Okay, so in this video we are going to correct the layout files with our URL and asset, so that we can get the path. Okay, we need to correct the paths of all the images, like all the images paths, CSS path, okay, jQuery path, so JS path. Okay, so all the paths we need to correct in this video so that our home page will look similar to this one, this static page. Okay, it will look like this one. Okay, so this thing we are going to do in this video. In last video you have seen that we have created this index controller in which the index function is there, and from where we have called the index blade file. Okay, so see, this one we have called in the last video. So in this video we are going to work on this index blade file. We need to correct the path here. Asset is required for all images. Okay, you know that in Laravel we need to get the path of the images with the help of a set. Okay, a set function is required, built-in function of Laravel is required to fetch the images. Okay, and JSCSS path is also required. You need to update this one front layout file as well. Here all CSS paths we need to correct. Okay, we will add URL for all these paths, and also front footer, front header and front sidebar we are going to update as well. Okay, so let's start. So first of all we are going to update our front layout file. I'm going to update. Okay, so let's update our front layout file. Okay, so these paths I am going to correct. So I will select all the paths together. Okay, so see, our front.min.css and other CSS files are located under, you can open, you can check out the path here, are located under public CSS, where is CSS, here it is, CSS, and after front underscore CSS, and here are all the files located. You can check out the path. If you are in Windows, you can easily check out the path. Here in Mac, you can check out the path like this. Okay, it's in htdocs, ecom, okay, ecom is our folder name, then public CSS and front CSS. So it will be like public slash CSS slash front underscore CSS. Okay, so this is the path. Okay, so I'm going to correct this path for all these CSS together. Like these are three CSS. Okay, so I am going to correct these paths like this. URL will come here, and after that CSS will come here like this, and then front underscore CSS like this. Okay, so now this one and this one as well. Now okay, done. So we have corrected all CSS paths, and after that see, there are more CSS paths, this one also we need to correct. So I will manually correct this one, URL and themes here also. We are going to check that pretty theme is not here, it's under JS. Okay, so I'm going to check public JS and underscore JS, and yeah, Google Pretty, so fine. So it's under JS, so we need to add here JS path. Okay, so I will correct all the JS part together as well, like theme JS. Okay, I will select all these paths together and we'll do like this. So URL, inside URL it will come like JS, inside JS our folder name is front underscore JS like this, and under front underscore js. This is not required like this. Okay, so these are all corrected. So now here I am manually ending this one like this, but here I will do all together like this. Okay, so I will correct all these together like this. Okay, so all JS files are also corrected. So now we need to set the images path. So for images, I will select like this, themes, images. Okay, so all I am going to select, and after that we'll add a set. Okay, and our images will come first. Images will come here. After that, front underscore images, and after that this one will come. So now I need to correct this one as well. For all, we'll do like this. So now I'm going to check whether some of some issue is coming, expecting. So some path is incorrect. I'm going to check and client 20. So here here it is left. Okay, this one here we need to end this like this. Okay, so now I go back and will refresh. Now this time you can see some part of the page is appearing now. Okay, so still there are issues because we still need to correct some of the things, but some are now visible. Okay, so we can open its console. You can right click and inspect element in every browser. Even if you are working on Windows, you can see the console will be there. You can open the console and go to network and check that which things are not opening. Okay, so it will tell you exactly that which things are not opening, like front.min.css is not opening, so we can correct it. Okay, so that we will come to know that which things are not opening. Here we need to correct the path as well. CSS, then slash front underscore CSS, then themes will not come up here, so it means that we are left this theme. So there is the issue. So this one we need to remove. So we have left with this one. Sorry, now it will work fine. Okay, still CSS will not come up here. Now it is fine. CSS slash front underscore CSS. Okay, so you can check now. Wow, so lot of the things are now appearing. Okay, so our home page is identical to this one, but still there are a few things, like you can see images are not coming up because still we need to update the other pages. Okay, so we are going to update other pages as well. In the same way, I'm going to update the index.blade.php file. Okay, so we are going to create the path in this index blade file as well. Okay, so here as well I am going to give the images path. Images are the main concern here. Okay, so I am going to select all the images together and going to move this one themes. Then I will add a set here, then it will start, then after images there will come front underscore images like this. Okay, so it is fine. Now I will select .jpg. I will select all .jpg all together and will end here like this. So now I can try and we'll check it out. So you can see now images are also coming. Okay, so see here all the images are coming up. T-shirts are coming now. Okay, you can see now it looks better. Okay, still there are few things that are not coming, so we are going to check other files as well. So I'm going to check front header whether some of the images, because see in header, footer and main page and main section, this one is the main section, you can see only images path you need to correct. But in front underscore layout file, you need to correct images, you need to create the CSS, you need to create the JS files. Okay, so so you can keep this in your mind. And now see in front header, I don't think there is any image, so we can left it. So I will open front footer and in front footer I'm going to check. Yeah, there are some images, so I'm going to check the images here and we'll put their path as well. I will correct set images and inside images front underscore images. Okay, so now you can see now it is appearing. Footer we have updated. Now still some of the things are having issue, like this one, these icons. Okay, so now this time we need to update one more file. We need to update our font epsom css. There are fonts path as well. We have not updated the font path, so you can check our fonts are located in public folder. Okay, see public and then folder, and here you can see font must be here only. See, the font folder is directly under public folder, so we need to set it path as well. Okay, so I'm going to set it path here. I am going to select all the like this one here, only single slash is required as it's directly under public folder. Okay, so now we are going to check. Now you can see now it is appearing. Okay, so now everything is appearing and you can now compare, and still there are few things that are having issue. We have not updated front sidebar, so we need to update our front sidebar as well. And here also, if there are any images, yeah, there are few images here as well, so we are going to update these images as well. PNG also we are going to update. Okay, so now you can check here PNG set and okay, sorry, still I forgot images, then front underscore images. Now it must appear. Now you can check, these icons are also appearing. Okay, so now you can check everything is fine or not. See, this home page is under Laravel. Okay, this is the home page of our Laravel website. Okay, you can see everything is coming fine. Okay, its header is coming, this script is also working. Okay, and you can see this one feature items, and these one are also coming fine, and this one is also coming. So everything seems to be perfect, similar to the HTML file. Now it's our Laravel file. Okay, we have updated the complete home page. Okay, and we have corrected all the paths. Okay, asset URL and we have set all the paths. Okay, now it is working fine. Okay, so now one more thing we need to do in this video. See, you can see this part. This part is the part of the home page only. These home page header banners, you can see, is the part of home page, and it must not come in any other page. If you will open the design, okay, if you will open the design folder that we have downloaded the last time, then you can see that it's not located in listing and any other page. You can see, you can open any other page like listing page, it is not coming. So this part belongs to the home page only, and we need to show it in under home page only. But right now it is coming in all the pages if we will not add any condition. So here we need to add one condition that just bring this part under home page. Okay, so for bringing this condition, we need to do one thing here. We will open the index controller, open the index function. Okay, so here see, we need to add one thing that will differentiate one page with other, and we can put one thing in one page and we can put some other thing in another page. Okay, so we are going to separate all the pages, and one condition we are required for that. So we will add the page name. Okay, page name like this. Okay, so this will tell that which page you are working in. So I'm just going to make it index. Okay, you can make it caps if you want, or you can do as per your requirement. I'm going to make it like this, index. Okay, so here I'm going to send this one with return this one like this with compact page name, so that everywhere it will show the page name as index when anyone open the index page. Okay, so okay, so now it seems to be fine. Yeah, you can, if you want, you can make it small as well, like this one, similar to the function. Okay, it's your choice. So what I'm going to do here, I'm going to compare this one in our front layout file where we are displaying those banners. So I will open front layout. So here you can see these banners, first thumbnail, banner test, banner test, banner test, these are appearing there. So this is the part that we want to show in home page only. So here we will add one condition. So we will add that if, first of all, we will check whether the page name is coming. So for that is set, we will add, and sorry, condition, first condition, get of if, then is set, we will add, inside is set, we will add the page name, that page name is coming or not. And if page name is coming, then we are going to check the page name with the page name that we have given, and that will be equal to index, like this. Okay, so here we will show this part only if the condition is true. Okay, so we will do like this. Fine. So you can see the page name, we have added the condition page name equal to index, only then this one is will come, otherwise it will not come. So I'm going to refresh here, see this one will come. Okay, so if I will change the condition, like if I want that it will come only in listing page, okay, though listing page does not exist at all, then this part will not come, this part will not come in home page. Just for checking the condition is working fine or not that we have added, just I am just testing, so that this condition, now it will not come. So this part has gone away, you can see there, that part has been gone away because we have added the listing. Whenever we will add listing page, that part will come under listing page only. Okay, so our condition is working fine. So we just want to bring this part under index page. Okay, so it will come on index page only, and it is coming right now, you can see. Okay, so we have make this portion dynamic so that it will come only under index page. Still it is not dynamic. These banners we will add from admin panel, that we will do some other time. Yeah, we will do very soon. Okay, and along with other things, we are going to not update only this one, we will also update this feature product dynamically. We will also update this one header portion dynamically. Okay, we will also update this sidebar dynamically. We will also update these feature products and latest products also dynamically. Okay, so everything in our homepage will come dynamic, and not only in homepage, in our complete website, everything will come as dynamic. Most of the things are will come at dynamic. Okay, main detail page, listing page. Okay, so so stay tuned for that. In next video, we will start working on making these things dynamic in our home page. Okay, so that thing we are going to do in our next video. Okay, so that's all for now, and if you have any queries, you can surely contact me in video description. Okay, so that's all for now. Have a nice time. Goodbye.